Thanks, sir.
For 5 years to fly training and tactical missions with the Navy.
The A4 Skyhawks have had a checkered career. Australia was the first country to buy them from the United States. They served on the aircraft carrier HMAS Melbourne, were withdrawn from Navy service in 1984 and sold to New Zealand for $28.2 million. Now six of the Skyhawks are back in a cross-leasing deal that will see them fly missions with Australian ships and train with RAN personnel. New Zealand will pick up the bill for maintenance and aviation fuel costs.
The arrangements that we now have will reduce the previous arrangements by a cost factor of some two-thirds, and that will be something that will never be lost on the taxpayer.
The jet's arrival was preceded by a welcome to the New Zealand crews and their families. The Kiwi contingent comprises 117 men, women and children. They'll spend at least 2 years at the Naval Air Station before being rotated. The Skyhawks' initial missions will orientate the pilots and alert them to local conditions.
Let them see the other airfields around the district in case we have to ever divert to those fields because of weather, and to get used to listening to Australian air traffic controllers.
Over the next 5 years, the Navy will pay $50 million for the privilege of exercising with planes we once used to own.
Nearly a decade ago, planes like this A4 Skyhawk were the pride of the Fleet Air Arm, Australia's frontline naval defence. Since then, our only aircraft carrier has been scrapped, and the Skyhawk sold to New Zealand, leaving the Navy with no fixed-wing craft. The idea was for the RAAF's FA-18s to provide air support and training, but the Navy has now turned across the Tasman to find a sparring partner. New Zealand Air Force No. 2 Squadron is now based at Nowra on the New South Wales coast, providing essential training for the Australian Navy.
Our Air Force has got its own priorities and a number of difficulties. Finance is tight these days, and we have to try and use our money as best we can. And of course, the A4 Skyhawk is far cheaper to operate than an F-18.
The Kiwis have moved the entire squadron and some families to Nowra as part of a $50 million contract over 5 years. Ironically, they're flying some of the same planes Australia sold years ago. Their part of the contract is to test naval weapon systems, provide targets and simulate attacks.
The Skyhawk is the only offensive air asset that New Zealand has, and because of that we're basically jack of all trades, you could say. So because we practice that in New Zealand, we can quite readily slip into any of the tasks that may be required of us.
And although the arrangement is breaking new ground for the Defence Forces, there have been no ministerial welcomes or publicity parades. It seems Australia is keen to keep the Kiwis low-key.